Hello, kindergarten. Miss Gallardo here. I hope you guys are doing well. I hope you guys are staying indoors and you're lounging in your comfy clothes all day long. I know I am. Don't tell anybody that. Excuse me. Okay, so today's assignment, you guys are going to be drawing a leprechaun in honor of St. Patrick's Day yesterday. So today we're going to be drawing the little guy. So we're going to need a pencil. You guys are going to need an eraser. If your pencil has an eraser on the end, you can use that, of course. If you guys want to use markers, you totally can. I got my markers here. If you want to use crayon, you can. I'll probably use both. Okay, so whenever you're ready, you guys can start with me. If you need to pause this video and get all your supplies, please do so. I'm going to get started. I'm playing some background music, so hopefully you guys can hear it. So we're going to be working, portrait style. So kiddos know that portrait style is the long way. It looks like an iPhone. It looks like a phone. Landscape looks like a television screen. So they know the difference between the two. So today we're going to be working portrait style. Okay? So as always, you guys write your names on the back. Turn it over. Okay. So first we're going to start with our little leprechaun's hat. So at the very top here, you guys are going to make two lines, and I'm drawing upside down, so just bear with me. Ah, don't look straight at all. Yeah, it's okay. Then you're going to add his little hat. Something like that. We're going to go down. Okay, I'm going to turn this. I'm not that skilled. I thought I was. Nope. Okay. So we have that there. Okay, so right in the middle here, we're going to make a square. Okay. Then you guys are going to make a line in the background. Like that. And then you're going to make another line in the background, just like this one. Okay. So now what we're going to do is we're going to add his face. So we're going to make a half circle that looks something like this. And you know what? Everyone's just going to look different, and that's okay. That is A-okay. Okay, so at the bottom here, we're going to make half circles all the way around his face here. And I think you guys are able to see now what's going on. This is your leprechaun's beard. Kind of looks like Abe. About that, right? What if we did something like that? Okay, so we need two eyeballs. So one eyeball there and one eyeball there. Okay. So my little guy is going to be looking inward. So we're going to make two circles in there. Like that. And another circle right here. And another circle right here. I'm going to color the, we're going to shade in the circle with pencil. I'm going to turn this around because I feel like it doesn't look right. Yeah, it's okay. And we're going to give this guy some eyebrows. His eyebrows are going to look something like that. Okay. A little circle for his nose. He's got a little smirk, so he's like, he looks like he's up to something, right? Okay, so on the corners here, you're going to add some more little hairs. So it's going to look something like that. Just like that. Okay, so now we're going to draw his body. Sorry, I keep moving things around. Okay, paints and his body's gonna look something like this. And then you're gonna go down here. And go up. And something like that. Okay. So now down here, I'm gonna make his shoes. So I'm gonna go one, and then I don't want it to, you know, I'm gonna erase that. It's gonna have to be a little bigger. Okay, one more shoe. Something like that. I'm gonna add his little legs, go up, and from that center point, you're gonna try and go to that center point, and then go up. Couple lines here, couple lines there, like that. Okay, what is he missing? He needs his arms, right? So let's go ahead and add his arms now. So we're gonna go one there, get like a little, like an oval, and then like, kind of like a half circle, but it's going off the paper there, okay? Gonna do another one. Okay, and then you're gonna make another oval. And then like a circle like that. So he's like, give me a hug. Okay, so in the middle part here, you're gonna try your best and make a clover. So clovers look a lot like hearts, okay? But I'm not gonna close it. It's gonna be open like that. So just the top part. Okay, so let's make another one here. Just like that. Let's make another one right here. Okay, just like that. Then he needs a little stem. Go ahead and make a little stem there. If you guys want to erase these lines, go ahead and erase them. Erase this one here. And then you're gonna try and connect it like that. Okay. There we go. So we're gonna give him a little background here. So add a line there, then add a line there. Just like that. Okay. Then he needs like a little collar. I'm gonna add a little collar here for him. Sorry. Drawing upside down is not that easy. Okay, that'll do it. And then we're gonna add some little buckles here for him. So just try your best with your buckles. They kind of look like little squares, like that. And then some squares inside. So now we're gonna get to coloring him, okay? All right, so let's go ahead and get our markers. If you guys need to pause, go ahead and pause it, and then play when you're ready. All right, so I'm gonna use two types of green. So I have my dark green, and I should have a light green, but I don't know if it works. I guess I'll try and test that green out. So I have like two shades of green, okay? All right, so his hat, we're gonna color in his hat green. So go ahead and trace your pencil lines here, okay? And then I'm not gonna trace here. I'm just gonna come over here and trace this pencil line, trace over it. Trace over here, and I'm going to trace down here, but not right there, okay? And trace up over here, I guess down and over for you, okay? Okay, and I'm going to color him in with my marker. This frame looks very tealish. I don't know if you guys can see that, but it's really not the green that I wanted, but it'll do, I guess. Oh no, this mess is running out. He's on his last leg. I'm going to get a little post-it. I don't want to get the marker on my clipboard here. So right underneath like that. Okay, I'm gonna color in this part here. Okay, so I'm gonna switch markers because this one's like really running out. Okay, so now what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna color in his clover here. So I'm gonna trace it first and then I'm gonna color him in. There we go. That's a pretty green now. Now we're talking. Stem's also going to be green. Okay, I'm going to color him in. So you guys will only have one assignment this week, okay? So your assignment is going to be due by next Wednesday, the 25th, okay? So you have 1 full week to complete this drawing, okay? So if you guys finish today, awesome! Take a picture and then send it to me, okay, on Class Dojo. So I can give you guys some participating points and I can give you guys credit for the week. Okay. Okay. So then now his little ovals here, like his little sleeves, I'm gonna color those in that same green. Okay. Over here too. Okay, and I'm gonna keep it like that. If these colors here can be the same green, that would be great, but if it's not, that's okay. Like, I kind of messed up because my marker decided to run out on me, so it's okay. Yellow is next. So I'm going to color in his hat here, yellow. Okay. Color the whole thing in yellow. And then his little collar here is going to be yellow. Okay. I'm playing some kids' mop in the background. I don't really know these songs. I wonder if you guys do. Okay, so his little trim here is going to be yellow. The background here. Okay, so his pants right in the middle here, we're going to color it in yellow. So just this middle part. Okay, and then over here. Okay, his little buckles are going to be yellow. And when you guys send me a picture of your work, be sure to send you yourself too, like you holding your picture, because I want to see you. I really miss you guys, so I would love to see your little faces. Okay, so now I'm gonna color in crayon now. So my light green color crayon, I think it's yellow green. I'm gonna color inside his shirt that color. I don't think this marker works. It looks really, really dry, so I'm not going to chance it. So just color inside of his shirt now. Take your time. And if you guys have any questions or anything, just send me a message on Fastojo and we'll write you back. Okay, so then his arms here are going to be that same color green. And if you guys need to pause it because I'm going too fast, pause it. And then work when you're ready. Okay. So then let's look at his pants here. If you want to get like an orange color, orangey, maybe the same orange that we did with his. Oh, we haven't done his hair yet. We will do his hair next. Actually, let's do his hair now. So we're gonna color in his hair. He's got orange hair. He's too cute. I can't wait to see your guys' drawings. So kindergarten, I'm sure you already know, because I just found out yesterday and I was like so excited to tell everybody, but Frozen 2 is on Disney Plus, guys. Maybe you have it, maybe you don't, but I thought that was really cool. It's like a really early time to do that, so it's pretty neat, right? then you're gonna color in here and here a orange. So let's go ahead and do that. I'm gonna trace it first. Okay. Okay. Color in it. Okay, and trace. Over here now. This is a cute little song. Okay, over here. Trace it and then color it in. And then he needs his little eyebrows to be orange too, to match his hair. But of course, okay, now these little hairs popping out. Let's color those in orange too. Okay. Okay. So then now what I'm gonna do is, let's see, his shoes. His shoes are going to be green. It should be like the same color, but I'm going to choose the marker that works. So I'm going to just color his shoes in green. Get my post-it back. Okay, color it all in. Come over here and do the same thing. Just outlining it first. And then color it in. Okay. Alrighty, so now what we're going to do is we're going to color him in. His skin tone. So I always tell you guys to choose the color that you are, okay? So whatever color your shade is, you're going to color him in that color. If you want to choose a different color, by all means, go for it, okay? So I chose an apricot color. But in the summertime, I am super, super tan, so I would change his color if it was summertime. I like to get real tan in the summertime. Okay. These are his little hands. I'm going to color his hands. Okay, so now his face. I'm going to color in his face. So you guys want to be careful, like, around his eyes. Because you don't want to get that pencil in your crayon. Because then it looks discolored. Doesn't look like the same color. It gets all weird. It gets all wacky. Okay, so I'm just kind of tracing around his nose and his eyes. And his little mouth here. I'm kind of going around it. Because I don't want to get that pencil. See how it's kind of happening there? Gotta be really careful. Okay. Okay, so now I'm going to go in and color his face. Make sure you guys send me pictures and of you too, okay? And then see your little faces. Okay, If you guys have a Sharpie or like a black crayon, maybe you can trace over his little mouth here. Only if you do. If you don't, it's fine. He is like so cute. Can't even handle it. I'm gonna leave it like that. Okay, so your background, okay? We're gonna try and do a rainbow, okay? All right, so rainbow, order of a rainbow. We went over that in the beginning of the year. So red would be your first color, right? Okay, so I'm just gonna go like just lines, okay? And I'm gonna use markers. And I'm gonna color it in crayon, okay? So red there. It's got a red crayon. If you guys don't want to do a rainbow, you don't have to do a rainbow. Maybe you want to do just like blue, like a sky, or maybe you want to do something else. Whatever you want to do, okay? If you guys want to follow me, go for it. If not, you don't have to. Okay? If you guys need to take a break and say, like, gosh, I want to do this maybe on Friday or Saturday, you guys can do that. Okay? No problem, though. Okay, so orange is next, right? So maybe an orange crayon. And I'm going to go ahead and color this for orange. I like to put my finger there so it like stops me from getting in it over here. So I can put my finger right there. Okay. Alright. Same over here. Alright, so what color is next? Yellow. Alright, yellow crayon. Yellow. Yellow crayon now. And what comes next, boys and girls? Green, right? All right, let's get some green back here. I'm going to use a dark green crayon, not my light green crayon. Okay. Come over here. Okay, then what color is next? Blue. You want to use a dark blue, light blue, whatever you want. So we're going in the background now, okay? So let's find a blue crayon. I'm going to trace around it first, so I don't want to get any crayon or another color in one of my leprechaun here. Okay, now we got over here. Can't wait to see your guys' work. That's always the best part when you guys show me your work. And they all look different, and they're all your own style. It's too cute. So the next color is what? Purple. Okay. All right, color this bright and purple. Okay, then I always tell you guys, if you have space, you guys can add pink. So we have space here, so you don't need to add a line, okay? Only if you want to, but you really don't have to. I'm just going to color this part in pink, okay? If you want to add that marker, you can, but it's not really needed. Okay. Whoops. Like it doesn't there. Okay, so that completes your leprechaun. If you guys want to sign your name, you can. Maybe you want to write your name like in the corner. Only if you want to. Maybe you want to put like your initials, right? I don't know. Let's see, like Aiden, he would be what? Aiden, so A-B, or Lily would be like L-R. Okay, I'm just going to write my last name. You guys can sign your beautiful work. All right, you guys, that does it. Send me a picture. I miss you so much. Okay, I'll see you guys super, super, super soon. Okay.